earthly and spiritual Israel, the 144,000. The Third Testament, Revelations of Jesus Christ, chapter 39. The historic mission of Israel, its failure. Thus saith the Lord. Verily, I say to you, that if mankind had persevered within the law, which their conscience dictated inwardly, it would not have been necessary to send you guides, nor prophets, nor would it have been necessary for your Lord to descend among you, even to engrave my law in stone during the first era, or having to become human and die as a man upon a cross in the second era. If I formed a people and lavished them with gifts, it was not so they could exalt themselves and humiliate others, but rather for them to be an example of submission before the true God and an example of brotherhood among men. I chose this people so that they would be an instrument of my will on earth and carrier of my revelations, so they would invite everyone to live within my law, and so that all humanity would become the only people of the Father. If this people have suffered greatly in spite of being the chosen, it is because they believed the heritage was only for them, that their God could not have been a God for the pagans, because they regarded other people as strangers and did not share with them what the Father had entrusted to them. If I separated them for a time from other people, it was because I did not want them to become contaminated with wickedness and materialism. However, when they stuck obstinately to their egotism and regarded themselves great and strong, I demonstrated to them that their power and their greatness were false, and I permitted other nations to descend upon them and reduce them to servitude. Kings, pharaohs, and Caesars were their lords, when I had offered to be their lord. The Father, in his infinite love, again manifested himself to his people, to give them their freedom and remind them of their mission. And during this period, I have come to deliver to them my lessons of love, and it is only my gaze that is able to discover among mankind the sons of Israel, whom I am calling and congregating, so that they may receive the light of the Holy Spirit. I have come to manifest myself before your spirit, because the time is long gone when I spoke to you through nature and by means of material manifestations that you called miracles. Now you can feel me within your spirit, as well as deep inside your heart. During this era, Palestine has not been the witness of my manifestation, because it is not a specific place that I come to seek, but rather your spirit. I search for the people of Israel of the spirit, not of blood. For the people who have the spiritual seed that throughout all the eras they have received through my charity. The separation of the Jewish people into the earthly and spiritual creeds. It was necessary that the Father, after his parting, strike from the hands of his people on earth the land which had been entrusted to them from the time of their ancestors. From some of them it was taken as a restitution, and from others as a reward. For that land of Canaan, that beautiful Palestine of past times, was prepared by me only as a symbol of the true promised land of the Spirit. And upon stripping that people of those possessions, the materialist Jews roamed over the face of the earth, and on the other hand, the faithful, those who had always sensed my presence, remained awaiting my will, without pain at having renounced that inheritance from the past, knowing that the Father had conceded to them a new grace, the inheritance of his word, the divine word, and of his sacrifice and his blood. They lived fully in the third era, and in these days, my gaze finds my people of Israel still divided into two parts. One materialist, enriched by the goods of the earth for their own restitution, and shaking the foundations of the earth with their power. for they have placed the strength, the talent, and the graces that the Father poured out over their spirits in service to themselves, their ambition, and their greatness. See how that people has given proof of their strength, even within their materialism, in their sciences, their will, and their intelligence. Within, they guard anger from the hunger, the enslavement, the humiliations they suffered, and today, arrogant and strong, they have risen up to humiliate other peoples, to make them tremble at their strength, and to dominate them. Today, they are the satiated ones, and they are pleased to see the millions who are hungry and the great peoples as slaves, slaves of their money, of their strength, of their science, and of their ambition. I also see the other part of my people, the faithful and determined, those who have always known how to feel my presence, those who have always recognized my coming to men, those who have believed in my revelations, and who have obeyed and complied in spite of all. That other part is not only you who have been witnesses to my communication through human understanding in this time, for part of the people of spiritual Israel is scattered over the globe, and wherever any one of them is found, he or she receives my charity, feels my presence, is sustained by my bread, and awaits me, without knowing where I might come, nor in what form, yet they wait. However, those who do know how I have come, how I have communicated, those who know with certainty my revelations, those who are prepared for the times to come, are you who form part of the 144,000 chosen by me from the 12 tribes of that people. 144,000 who shall be before the numerous people of Israel, like 144,000 captains who will make it march into the great battle of the third era. Do you believe that my people will always be divided? Truly, I tell you, they will not. To you have come the teachings, the light and the trials. To them also my justice and trials have come. I led them in shine steps toward the awakening of the Spirit. And although it is true that in the first moments they will deny my third coming to the world, as they denied the second, I tell you, the moment of their conversion is not far off. They live in their ancient traditions, yet I probe the spirit and the heart of the Jewish people. And I tell you that they keep their traditions more for convenience and fear of spiritual revelations than from inner conviction. They tremble before the manifestations of the beyond. This is what I shall propose to them, that they give up all that is superfluous and practice charity, love, and humility. You shall have to come before them, and each shall wield their weapons. On one side, the word, thought, prayer, and evidence. The others, their talent, power, and traditions. But I shall be present in the struggle, and I will bring about the true triumph of my justice. Bring about the triumph of spirituality. I will make the spirit rise over the flesh, that it bows it and humiliates it. Then shall come the reconciliation of the tribes of Israel, and the unification of the people of the Lord. When that people is prepared, truly I tell you, they will take up and carry to completion the great mission with which from the beginning of time God has assigned his chosen people, chosen because they were his firstborn and the bearers of the Lord's revelations, so that, like an older brother, they could lead the others, share his grace with them, and carry all to the right hand of the Father. The spiritual people of Israel. When I speak of my people of Israel, the people of God, I refer to those who have brought a spiritual mission to earth, those who made known my law, those who proclaimed me, those who were faithful, those who proclaimed the existence of the living God, those who perpetuated the seed of love, and those who knew how to recognize in the Son, the Word, and the presence of the Father. These are those that form the people of God. That is Israel, the strong, the faithful, the prudent Israel. That is my legion of soldiers, faithful to the law, faithful to the truth. Those who persecuted my prophets, who lacerated the heart of my envoys, those who turned their backs on the true God to bow before idols, who denied and mocked me, demanding my blood and my life. Those, although by race called Israelis, were not the chosen people, were not of the people of the prophets, the legion of the enlightened, of the faithful soldiers, for Israel is a spiritual name that was taken incorrectly to designate a race. You should also know that all who aspire to form part of my people can do so by means of their love, charity, and their zeal and faithfulness for the law. My people has no fixed lands or cities in the world. My people has no race, but is found among all races throughout humanity. That proportion of mankind that hears my word and receives the new revelations are only a part of my people. Another part is disseminated around the earth, and another, the greatest part, inhabit the spiritual veil. That is my people, those who acknowledge and love me, who obey and follow me. Today, I ask you, where is my people? Where is that people who were prudent when faced with trials, strong in battle, and steadfast in the struggles? It is dispersed throughout the world. Yet I shall raise my voice and reunite them spiritually, so that they may go before all the peoples. But I tell you that my people is now formed of men of all races, and they shall come to understand the alliance that I expect of all men. These people will be strong and combative, but shall not have weapons that kill, nor the chariots of war. Neither shall they sing hymns of destruction. Their banner shall be peace, their sword truth, and their shield love. None can discover where that people is, but it shall be everywhere. Its enemies will try to destroy it, but will not be able, for they shall never be gathered physically. Their union, their order, and their harmony shall be spiritual. In this time, the spirit of the real Israel vibrates everywhere. They are the spirits that feel my presence, that await my coming, and trust in my justice. When these words come to other places, many will mock them. But I tell you that it would be better that they did not mock, for the time will come when they awaken from their lethargy and know that they too are children of the people of God. These multitudes that today hear me might fall into confusion if they do not study my word, and if they do not put off their materialism. The same may happen to them as to the Israelites of the earliest times, who heard the voice of the Lord, received the law, and had prophets, so they came to believe themselves the only people beloved of God. A grave error from which the great trials came to save them, humiliation, exile, and captivity. It is necessary that you know that my love could not segregate you in races or creeds in which I speak of my people. It is because from the first times I have been preparing spirits to be sent to earth to illuminate the path of humanity. They have been the eternal travelers that have inhabited the various nations and have passed through many trials. In this time, they have found that human laws are unjust, that there is no truth in the affections, and no peace in the spirit of humanity. The people of God shall rise up once again among humanity, not as a people personified in a race, but as a multitude, a legion of my disciples, in which only the spirit, and not any blood, race, or language shall dominate. This people will not limit themselves to teaching my doctrine through writings, so that the words have life, it is necessary to live them. This people shall not disseminate only books and writings, but also deeds and examples. Today, I am freeing you of all that is superfluous, all that is impure or wrong, so that you may enter into a life that is simple and clean, from which your spirits can ascend, offering testimony by its works. When the time has come, I will present my people to humanity, and the Master shall not be embarrassed by his disciples, nor shall his disciples deny their Master. That moment will coincide with the war of ideas, from which shall arise, like the relief of peace, like a ray of light, spiritualism. My people grows, it multiplies, not only on earth, but also in the spiritual valley. Among those spiritual multitudes are found those who had blood ties with you, whether they were your parents, your brothers, or your children. Do not be surprised when I tell you that my people is so numerous that the earth to hold them would have to be much larger. When I have reunited them, and not even one of my children is missing, they will be given the infinite as their dwelling, that never-ending valley of light and grace. Here on earth, I come only to prepare you, to instruct you in my doctrine, so that you know how to approach that life. This humanity is only a portion of the people of God. It is necessary that all know these explanations in order to put their lives on the road to the ideal of perfection. This divine message, which is my word poured out through the lips of the human spokesman, I wish it to reach all humanity. My word is the ringing bell that calls the world. Its essence shall move the peoples, making them awaken to meditate on spirituality, on the destiny of the spirit after this life. The 144,000 chosen. To extend my work in this, the third era, I have come to choose, from among the great masses, 144,000 spirits, marking them by the kiss of divine light. Not a kiss of betrayal, nor the sign of a pact that would put your spirit in danger. My mark is a sign that the Holy Spirit deposits upon those it has chosen to carry out a great mission in this, the third era. He who bears this sign is not safe from dangers. On the contrary, he is tried and tempted more than any. Remember, each one of the 12 chosen by me in the second time, and you can confirm what I tell you. They had moments of doubt, of weakness, and of confusion. There was even one who betrayed me to my executioners with a kiss. How much the chosen of this time shall have to pray and keep vigil to not fall into temptation. Even so, I tell you truly that among the 144,000 there shall be traitors. The mark means a calling, missions, and responsibility before God. It is not a guarantee against temptations or illnesses. If it were, what merit would there be in my chosen? What effort would it be for your spirit to remain faithful to my word? I speak to you in this way because there are many hearts among this multitude that would wish to form part of those who have been marked. But I have seen that rather than the yearning to serve humanity with the gifts that the mark bestows, it is the desire to feel secure or vanity that moves them to ask me to call them. I will test these petty ones, and they will be convinced that there is truth in my words. The mark is an invisible sign by which those who bear it with love, respect, zeal, and humility can complete their mission. You will then see that the mark is a divine grace that is superior to pain, that illuminates you in your greatest trials, that reveals profound knowledge, and which, in any place, can open a breach for the passage of the Spirit. The mark is like a link, uniting whoever possesses it to the spiritual world. It is the channel by which the thoughts and words of the spiritual world manifest in yours. Know then by my words that the marked one is a messenger, an envoy, and my instrument. The commitment and responsibility of the marked one toward my work is great, but he is not alone on his path. By his side, there walks a guardian angel who protects, guides, inspires, and strengthens him. Oh, how strong has been he who knows how to embrace his cross with love, and how hard and bitter has been the road of the chosen one who has not known how to carry with him the divine sign of the chosen in the third era. I tell all you who hear me, learn to pray and keep vigil, to carry your cross with love and practice righteousness and obedience, so that this life, which has been the most luminous reincarnation of your spirit, is not sterile, making you lament the time lost and the gifts unused. Meditate, all of you, marked or unmarked, on this lesson, for all of you have a destiny to fulfill within my work. The tribes of the Israel of the Spirit are very numerous. From each I will select 12,000 and shall mark them on their foreheads. But the people of Israel are not limited to 144,000. The chosen people is infinite. The Master taught you in the second era that many are called, but few are chosen. And all of Israel shall be called, but from among them I shall mark out 144,000. In all I shall place peace, spirituality, and the principle of spirit-to-spirit communication. I am the Universal Father. My love descends to all hearts. I have come to all the peoples of the earth. Yet if I have chosen this Mexican nation as the place for the full outpouring of my word and my revelations, it is because I found it to be humble, have found the virtues in their homes, and have made the spirits of the people of Israel reincarnate among them. Yet not all belong to this nationality, nor are all in flesh. The spirits belonging to the number of the chosen are disseminated throughout the world. They have been marked. I have opened their eyes. I have sensitized their hearts. And from spirit to spirit, they communicate with me. One part of the 144,000 marked by me live among humanity. Those servants of mine are found disseminated in the world, complying with the mission of praying for peace and working for the brotherhood of men. They do not know each other, but some intuitively and others because of this revelation are fulfilling their destiny of throwing light onto the path of their brothers. Of those marked by my love, some are simple men, but others are men notable in the world. They can only be distinguished by the spirituality of their lives and works, and by the manner of their thinking about and of understanding the divine revelations. They are not idolaters, fanatics, nor frivolous. They seem to practice no religion, and nonetheless, from them arises an inner worship of their spirit with that of their Lord. Those marked by the light of the Holy Spirit are like lifeboats. They are guardians, counselors, and strongholds. I have equipped them with light in their spirits, and with peace, strength, with the healing balm, with keys that invisibly open the most stubborn doors, and weapons that overcome obstacles insuperable to others. It is not necessary that they show titles awarded by the world for their gifts to be recognized. They do not know science, but are doctors, do not know law, but are counselors, are poor in the goods of the earth, but yet may do much good in their way. Among these multitudes who have come to receive my word are many who have come only to confirm their mission. For it is not on the earth that they have been given gifts or been entrusted with a charge. I tell you truly, the delight that each spirit possesses is that which it has earned on the long road of its evolution. Humanity will believe. My work will be spread throughout the globe. I shall begin with the 144,000 marked out, who shall struggle with obedience, love, and zeal in the time of the wars of beliefs and doctrines, and who in the midst of that battle shall be a link that proposes to the world not the chains of slavery, but that of spiritual alliance that will be one of freedom and brotherhood. Those soldiers shall not be alone. My spiritual world shall follow and protect them. They shall perform marvels as they go, and in this way, giving testimony to my truth.